Have you ever wondered why we can't handle vulnerability? Hey everybody, I'm Dov and I'm one half of Twin Flame Revolution. We are transformative mentors and motivational speakers. We work with your personal development, business, and relationships. And today I'm going to be talking about something that has come to be very near and dear to me as an understanding of how we interact with one another, which is what is one of the main reasons that we actually can't handle the sensation of vulnerability. So first I want to start talking about what vulnerability means to me in this context. Vulnerability is this sense of being heart open, being able to feel other people, being able to let all the walls down, being able to feel a sensation of deep intimacy, right? And you know when you've fallen into that place where all of a sudden everything feels so tender and soft and good and you connect with everybody. But what we don't talk about is that it also feels very raw. And in that place of very raw and very vulnerable, the world and our modern society feels very abrasive. We have become less vulnerable. And by vulnerable, I don't mean wear your heart on your sleeve and tell people what you've gone through in your life, air out all your dirty laundry on Facebook. I mean being able to feel into your heart, being able to share and connect with people. And in a very authentic and regular way. And you know, coming into those moments, I've looked around and realized it feels scary. It feels like an affront on all your senses, because what's actually happening for you is that all of those walls, all of those protections, all of those pieces that have made you able to go, 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 get to work, you know, put up the ability to handle with, you know, fighting in traffic, or maybe somebody having a bad day, or maybe being insulted, all of these pieces, your armor is put down when we are vulnerable and we allow ourselves to connect and be intimate, and the world feels like an affront to that. So it is actually quite hard for us to stay in that heart-centered space in our modern day society, with the way we interact in modern day society, with the way we don't understand how to have kindness, and we have aggression, and we expect to have to be, right? My puppy's agreeing if you were hearing those noises. If we have to be always on guard and protecting self, then we are not able to be in that state of vulnerability. And that state of vulnerability allows us to be in that loving, intimate space. And that loving, intimate space allows us to connect with who we are. And that ability to connect with who we are allows us to connect with those people that we love. And the ability to connect with those that we love allows us to connect with the world. This is one of the fundamental ways that we are able to change things. We are able to change things that simply by allowing ourselves to understand why. And so what I would leave you with is, if you are able to come to those places of vulnerability, if you are able to bring the walls down, if you're able to do the work to drop the walls down, then start to understand that the world is going to come at you like a wall, moving at 1,000 miles an hour, made of tons and tons of bricks or concrete. And you are going to have to say, pause, or wait, or I need a second, or I need support, or I need to find somewhere where I could share this. And I also really wanted to share this message to begin thought process. This is one of several messages, several videos that I wanted to make because I felt like we needed to start having conversation about this. We needed to start having conversation that allows us to think, and that thinking will allow us to shift, and that shifting will allow us to start to come up with solutions and ways to live a little bit differently. When we're in a very vulnerable state, it feels like we're wearing our emotions and our nerves on our skin. And so it feels terrifying. It feels terrifying to even engage with the outside world. It feels terrifying because we feel so much. It feels terrifying because that armor is down and the world is attacking, because the world is still in that state of affront and protection. So I want to leave you guys with the thought of, if this is so, how can we start to make it different? And how can you start to look at it differently in your own life? So I hope that this was thought-provoking and interesting. I'm going to ask you guys to share this if it resonated with you. And if you are new to us, please subscribe, like, and follow us. We will see you really soon. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. Talk to you soon.